Now in this video, we are going to use buttons in a much different way. As we have already seen how to create a drop down using a button, how to use a single button. But now here we will work with the button groups. Basically, if you'll put number of buttons at a group, it will give you a feeling of menu, right? So if you want to create a menu in your web page, you can actually go for this button groups and you can set different actions for the different buttons in the group. So let's start working with the implementation of button groups. So as we have already discussed about the buttons, here you can see I have added 3 buttons and the appearance will be like default, means the whitish buttons will be there. You can use it as per your requirement. And here I have taken a div inside which I have put all these 3 buttons, and the class which I am using with the div is btn group. So basically this btn group will group all these 3 buttons all together and they will be like physically attached side by side. So let's see how this output is looking like. So here you can observe like there are 3 buttons and they are just connected to each other because they are bound into a group. Alright, so now you can use some other classes as well in order to customize the output. Like we can just use multiple BTN groups inside a BTN toolbar. So if you want to make a toolbar for your web page, you can just group multiple BTN groups containing the buttons and then you can form a toolbar. So here you can see here are 3 BTN groups, like there is 1 button, 2 button group and 3rd button group. Alright, and I have just put them all inside one div where I am using a class BTN toolbar. So when I will do that, in the output it would be looking like this. Alright, so this is the set of first buttons, this is the set of second button group and this is the 3rd button group. So likewise, you can just start working on your buttons, like you can bound them in a button group and then you can bind multiple button groups inside button toolbar. If required, you can also just change the size of each button group using the same BTN group LG, SM and XS. Alright, so let's execute and see how these different button groups are looking like. So this one is the large, this one is small and this is extra small. So as per your window size, for the different screen size, you can just make a responsive menu for using these buttons and you can just apply the different button sizes as per the screen size. You can also put one button group inside another in case if you want to give some other appearance to your button. Like here what I am doing is there is BTN group, alright, inside which I have put 2 buttons. Now again inside this BTN group I have taken another where I am trying to make a button as a drop down list which we have done already. Alright, so in this way what it will be looking like, it will be the nested BTN group inside which the first 2 are from one group and again this is separated by another BTN group, but they all are being shown or displayed as a single group itself. Now all the appearances which I have shown right now is horizontal. Now let's see how can we make them vertical. So for that I just have to add one more class over here and I'll say BTN group vertical. I'll say that in both these situations, alright, in both the places. So let's execute it again. And here you can see now they are being arranged in a vertical way. So far when we were forming a drop down out of a button, we were actually putting the caret symbol in the same button. But if required, you can also make a group of 2 buttons in order to make the caret symbol on the another button. So here as you can see, in the first button I have just made it primary and put a text called .net, and right after that I have put another button where I am using it for toggling and I have applied a span with the class caret. When you will click over that, I will just form the menu in which I have currently shown 2 different elements. Alright, so here
In the button, you will get a text.net. When you will click on the caret symbol on the another button, it will show you a list containing these two elements. So let's see how it is looking like. All right, so here you can see this is the button with the text, and here when you will click over this, it will show you the menu. All right, so these are all the different usages of the BTN group class, and you can use it for various purposes while defining a web page.